नहीं, द क्वेश्चन इज इफ वन जेड वन जेड टू एंड जेड टेन आर 11th रूट्स ऑफ यूनिटी देन मैच द एंट्रीज इन कॉलम ए विद एंट्रीज इन कॉलम बी. नाउ वी नो दैट द 11th रूट्स ऑफ यूनिटी, देन वी कैन राइट जेड टू द पावर 11 माइनस वन एज जेड माइनस वन जेड माइनस जेड वन जेड माइनस जेड टू एंड z minus z10. I will divide everything with z minus 1. We can write z minus z1 z minus z2 z minus z10. It is z to the power 11 minus 1 upon z minus 1, and we'll take this limit z tends to 1 both sides. Now on the left hand side we'll have 1 minus z1 1 minus z2, 1 minus z10, and this is limit x tends to a, x to the power n minus a to the power n upon x minus a. So, it will be n a n minus 1, which is nothing but 11. So, this a, it matches with 4. Now, rather than taking z as plus 1, if we take z as minus 1, on the left hand side, we'll get this as minus 2. Here also, it'll be minus 2. And then minus 1 minus z1, minus 1 minus z2, and then minus 1 minus z10. Now this minus 2 and minus 2 will cancel. And here we have 10 factors. If we take minus 1 common from each factor, we'll get 1 plus z1 into 1 plus z2. 1 plus z10 and it'll be nothing but 1. So this c, it matches with 1. So c matches with 1. Now we look at d. D is nothing but product of all the roots. 1 into z1 into z2 into z10, it'll be minus 1 to the power n minus 1, which is 11 minus 1, which again is 1. So this d, it again matches with 1. So D, it matches with 1. Now what about option B? Now we know that sum of any powers of all the roots is 0 if the power is not a multiple of n, and it'll be n if power is multiple of n. Now 11 doesn't divide 100. So it simply means that 1 to the power 100 plus z1 to the power 100 up to z10 to the power 100 will be nothing but 0. So this B, it matches with 3. So B, it matches with 3. Now here the question is, how many pairs of real numbers A and B does this relation A plus B iota to the power 2020 equals A minus B iota? Now we'll let a plus b iota as z, we can write z to the power 2020 equals z bar. Now from here we'll get this condition that either mod of z is 0 or mod of z is 1. Now if mod of z is 0, we'll get one solution, and that is value of z is 0. Now we take this first case when mod of z is 0, we'll get the only solution, which is z equals 0. And if we consider the second case that mod of z equals 1, so what we'll do is we'll multiply z both sides, we'll write z to the power 2021 equals 1, that is z is 1 to the power 1 upon 2021, which is 2021th power of unity. So this equation will have 2021 roots. So total number of roots will be 2021 plus 1, that is 2022. So there will be 2022 real numbers A and B which satisfy this relation. Now here the question is, if alpha is non-real and it is 5th root of unity, we need to find the value of 2 to the power mod of 1 plus alpha square plus alpha to the power minus 2 and minus alpha to the power minus 1. Now we know that alpha to the power 5, it is 1. Then alpha to the power minus 2, it is nothing but alpha cube. And alpha to the power minus 1, it is nothing but alpha to the power 4. So we can write this as 2 to the power mod of 1 plus alpha square plus alpha cube minus alpha to the power 4. Now we'll add alpha to the power 4 and we'll subtract alpha to the power 4. Now sum of all fifth root of unity is 0. So this is 0 and we'll get this as 2 to the power mod of minus 2 alpha to the power 4. Now it'll be 2 square upon mod alpha to the power 4 and mod of alpha is 1. So it'll be 2 square, which is simply 4, and that's your option A. Now here the question is, if 1, x1, x2 and x3 are the roots of x to the power 4 minus 1 and omega is cube root of unity, then we need to find this value. Now we know that we can write x to the power 4 minus 1 as x minus 1 into x minus x1, x minus x2 into x minus x3. Now if we put x as omega square, it'll be omega to the power 8 minus 1 and it'll be equal to omega square minus 1 into omega square minus x1, omega square minus x2 and omega square minus x3. Now omega to the power 8 is nothing but omega square, so it'll cancel. From here we can write omega square minus x1 into omega square minus x2 into omega square minus x3, it is 1. Now for the denominator, we'll put x as omega. So we'll get this as omega to the power 4, which again is omega. So it'll be omega minus 1 equals omega minus 1, omega minus x1, omega minus x2 and omega minus x3. Now it'll cancel. So from here we'll get omega minus x1 into omega minus x2 into omega minus x3 will be equal to 1. Now we divide first with second, we'll get this result as 1. Now here the question is, if ZR are the roots of the equation z to the power 2m plus z to the power 2m minus 1, z to the power 2m minus 2 up to plus z plus 1, then prove that this summation r varies from 1 to 2n 1 upon zr minus 1 is equal to minus m. Now we can write this equation as z to the power 2m plus z to the power 2m minus 1 up to z plus 1 and it'll be equal to z minus z1, z minus z2 up to z minus z2m. Now if we take log both sides, we can write log and then summation z to the power r, where r varies from 0 to 2m, it'll be equal to this summation log z minus zr, where r varies from 1 to 2m. Now what we'll do is we'll differentiate both sides. We'll get 1 upon this summation r varies from 0 to 2m z to the power r, and then this summation r varies from 0 to 2m r into z to the power r minus 1, and on the right hand side we'll get this as this summation r varies from 1 to 2m 1 upon z minus zr. Now what we need is zr minus 1. So what we'll do is we'll put z as 1. Now, if you put z as 1, we'll get this as this summation 1, and summation 1 will be 2m plus 1 into, now this is summation r, and summation r is n plus 1 by 2, and it'll be this summation r varies from 1 to 2m 1 upon z minus zr. Now this 2m plus 1 will cancel, this 2 will also cancel. Now we'll take this minus common from the right hand side and we'll take it on the left hand side. So we can write this summation r varies from 1 to 2m 1 upon zr minus 1. Here this z, it should be 1. It'll be equal to minus m, and which is what we need to prove. Now here the question is, if omega to the power j are the nth roots of unity, then show that this summation j varies from 0 to n minus 1 mod of z1 plus omega to the power j z2 square, it is equal to n into mod of z1 square plus mod of z2 square. Now we know that mod of z square is z into z bar. So we can write this as this summation j varies from 0 to n minus 1. This is z1 plus omega to the power j z2, and then it will be z1 bar plus omega bar to the power j into z2 bar. Now omega bar to the power j is nothing but omega to the power n minus j. So we can write this summation as this summation j varies from 0 to n minus 1 z1 plus omega to the power j z2 and z1 bar plus omega to the power n minus j into z2 bar. Now we'll multiply them. If we multiply them, we'll get this as this summation j varies from 0 to n minus 1, and then z1 into z1 bar will be mod of z1 square plus, now here we'll get omega to the power n minus j z1 into z2 bar plus omega to the power j z2 into z1 bar, and then plus omega to the power n into mod of z2 square. Now omega to the power n, it is 1. So we can write this summation as summation j varies from 0 to n minus 1, and we'll take them together. It'll be mod of z1 square plus mod of z2 square plus z1 z2 bar, and then this summation omega to the power n minus j, where j varies from 0 to n minus 1, plus z2 z1 bar, j varies from 0 to n minus 1 omega to the power j. Now we know that sum of any consecutive n powers of omega is 0. So this is 0, and this sum is also 0, and this is a constant term. So this summation will be n times mod of z1 square plus mod of z2 square, and which is what we need to prove. Now here the question is, let z be a root of x to the power 5 minus 1 equals 0. That means z is fifth root of unity and z is unequal to 1. Now we need to find the value of z to the power 15 plus z to the power 16 up to z to the power 50. Now we know that sum of any n consecutive powers of roots is equal to 0. That means sum of any 5 consecutive powers of z will be nothing but 0. So if we look at these numbers, they start from 15 and they go all the way up to 15. So we'll have z to the power 15, and then plus this first set of consecutive powers from 16 to 20, then from 21 to 25, and finally from 46 to 50. Now sum of all these sets is nothing but 0. So this sum will be nothing but z to the power 15. Now since z to the power 5 is 1, z to the power 15 will also be 1. So value of this summation is nothing but 1, and that's your option A. Now example 30 is, we need to find roots of this equation. Now we are given this equation, which is z plus 1 to the power 5 and it is equal to z minus 1 to the power 5. Now we can write this as z plus 1 upon z minus 1, and this is fifth root of unity, and it is nothing but e to the power iota 2 pi r by 5. Now we'll use componendo and dividendo. So we'll get z upon 1 as 1 plus e to the power iota 2 pi r by 5 upon e to the power iota 2 pi r by 5 minus 1. Now what we'll do is, on the right hand side we'll divide numerator and denominator with e to the power iota pi r by 5. So we'll get this z as e to the power minus iota pi r by 5 plus e to the power iota pi r by 5 upon e to the power iota pi r by 5 and minus e to the power minus iota pi r by 5. Now this numerator is nothing but, this is 2 cos pi r by 5 upon, and this is 2 iota sine pi r by 5. So this zr, it will be minus iota cot pi r by 5. Now if we put r as 1, we'll get z1, which is minus iota cot pi by 5. Now we put z as 2, we'll get minus iota cot 2 pi by 5. Z3 is minus iota cot 3 pi by 5, and 3 pi by 5 is pi minus 2 pi by 5. So it'll be plus cot 2 pi by 5. In the same way, we can write z4 as plus iota cot pi by 5. So the roots are plus minus iota cot pi by 5 and plus minus iota cot 2 pi by 5, which is your option B. That says, if W is e to the power iota pi by 11, we need to find this product k varies from 0 to 11 omega to the power k minus 2 omega to the power minus k. Now we can write this as omega to the power minus k into omega to the power 2k minus 2, where this product, it varies from 0 to 11. Now we'll split it in two parts. So this product k varies from 0 to 11 omega to the power minus k into this product k varies from 0 to 11 e to the power iota 2 pi k by 11 minus 2. Now this first one, it is nothing but omega and then minus. This is sum of first 11 natural numbers. So it will be 11 into 12 upon 2, and here it will be k varies from 0 to 11, and this is 11th root of unity. So it will be alpha to the power k minus 2. Now we can write this as omega square to the power minus 11, and here we can write this as 1 into 2 minus alpha, 2 minus alpha square, 2 minus alpha to the power 10 and 2 minus alpha to the power 11. Now omega square is alpha and alpha is 11th root of unity. So alpha to the power 11 is 1. So this value is 1. This value is also 1. So we'll get this series as 2 minus alpha into 2 minus alpha square up to 2 minus alpha to the power 10. Now we know that if alpha is 11th root of unity, we can write z to the power 11 minus 1 as z minus 1, z minus alpha square, z minus alpha to the power 10. If we put z as 2, we can write 2 minus alpha up to 2 minus alpha to the power 10 will be 2 to the power of 11 minus 1. So value of this product, it will be 2 to the power of 11 minus 1, which is 2048 minus 1, and it is 2047. Now the question is, if beta n equals to 1 is any nth root of unity, then we need to find this sum. So this sum is 1 plus 3 beta plus 5 beta square. It continues up to 2n minus 1 beta to the power n minus 1. Now we'll write this series again, displacing it by one term and multiplying it with beta. So we'll get this as beta plus 3 beta square, and this is 2n minus 3 beta to the power n minus 1, and plus 2n minus 1 into beta to the power n, and we know that beta to the power n is 1. Now we'll subtract second from first. We can write 1 minus beta s will be 1 plus 2 into beta plus beta square up to beta to the power n minus 1, and here it will be minus 2n minus 1. Now we know that sum of this series is minus 1, so it will be 1 minus beta s and then minus 1 minus 2n plus 1. So sum of this series is minus 2n upon 1 minus beta, and that's your option 2.